Hey, what's up everyone? Welcome to Effects Maniac again. This is Sayed Mahmoud Amiri, and in this tutorial I will be showing you guys how to create this really cool melting effect using Phoenix FD and Tiflow inside 3D Studio Max. So let's check it out. I think the volume is a little high, so alright. So this one is kind of like a fast, low-res version, but then I also got a slow and high-res version, so let's see here. Alright, so it's looking pretty cool, and let's get started. Alright, so before getting into our today's tutorial, I just wanted to tell you guys that if you haven't subscribed to our new channel, Audio Aura, make sure to go ahead and subscribe and share it with your friends. We provide great high quality, royalty free, no copyright music for your video productions. All types of musics are there, and we basically try to upload every day, and you know, you can use them for whatever you want. Just help us and support us by subscribing to our new channel. It would mean a lot to me. And of course, if you haven't subscribed to my main channel, then make sure to do so. Alright, let's get into today's tutorial. So basically what I'm going to do is I'm going to create the text falling using Tiflow, and then we're going to go into Phoenix FD. So what I'm going to do is going to text and just type something here, maybe like word, right? And make sure we got like a bolder font. And the very important thing here is that you want to make sure you go to your customize unit setup and make sure it's centimeters, and unit setup, one unit is 1 centimeter, okay? Because if you want to get the same results as mine, so you need to be working in the same scale. So then I'm going to be adding a bevel modifier and just increase it a little bit to maybe like 25, not 255, 25. And level 2, height 1, and outline negative 1. So it'll basically give us like a little nice outline or bevel. And then I'm just going to rotate it. Make sure you hit A before you rotate it to turn on angle snap. It will snap like every 5 degrees. And that's about it. And I'm just going to make it small here. And just right click, convert it to editable poly. And we want to separate out every one of these letters. So I'm going to go into detach, okay, detach, detach, and that's it. All right, the next thing we're going to do is select all of them and just go into hierarchy tab and effect pivot only center to object. And if I'm going a little fast, you know, if you don't know the basics of 3ds Max, Tiflow, or Phoenix, make sure to tell me in the comments section. Maybe you want a basic, like an intro tutorial for 3ds Max or Tiflow or Phoenix. I can do that. Just make sure to tell me in the comments section below. Alright, so then I'm going to go into the geometry, Tiflow, and just create one out here. And just going to open the editor. And before doing that, I'm just going to move these letters up and just randomly hit E and rotate them around so that we get a little bit of a random sort of motion when they fall down. Alright, so that's about it. And I'm going to be adding a birth objects operator. Select them all and go add selected. And then just right click and hide these so that we have our Tiflow particles. So now these are basically particles. Objects turn into particles. Alright, so the next thing I'm going to do is turn them into dynamic objects, and simply we can do that by hitting tab and applying a physics shape modifier or operator and just drag it there and delete the display. So now we got our letters kind of falling down and doing its thing. So I want it to be 100 frames. Now I need to cache them as objects. Alright, so I'm just going to go hit tab and add an export particles node or operator and just set it to objects and export. Yes, that's it. So now we're going to delete our Tiflow, or you can hide it or whatever, but we got our objects animated. And now we're going to be using Phoenix FD to turn this into liquid and then kind of like make it splash, all right? So what I'm going to do is create our grid first. So I'm gonna go to Phoenix FD and just go here, liquid sim, and just drag it out here. Just a bit larger than the size of our, you know, our text. And then we don't want it to be too high. I just want it to make it high enough so that when the texts are up, it encompasses the whole area. So I'm just going to turn down the Z and that'll be it. And then in the example, as you can see here, they fall down and the floor is kind of like acting like the floor is acting as a floor, of course. So they fall down to the ground and they splash around. So the thing that enables us to do that is we can set our container walls for X and Y should be open, and for the Z it should be jammed both, meaning that whenever the simulation or the liquid touches either the top or the bottom of the grid, it will be used as a wall. And then the next thing is if I just set it right now, it will just like the liquid will splash only inside the container, which we don't want. We want it to like splash around as much as possible, as much as they go. So in order to do that, you can turn on the adaptive grid. It'll basically kind of expand itself according to the motion of the fluid. All right, so make sure to turn that on. And then the next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to go and create a liquid source. So go to helpers, Phoenix FD, and liquid source. So drag one out here. And I'm just going to be adding my objects to the liquid source node. So that'll be it. And the emit mode, I'm just going to set it to volume brush. And make sure to hit yes on this, because like normally if you have some objects inside Phoenix FD grid, it will be used as a collider with the liquid. But in this case, we don't want it to collide. We want it to emit from it. So just make sure that it is non-solid. So hit yes. And make sure to turn on viscosity and set it to 1. And the brush effect, we want to like keyframe it in 1 frame and then just keyframe it to 0. So turn on auto key, set key to 100 in the first frame, and then I'm just going to go into frame 1 and set it to 0, and that's basically it. So we have 100 and then we have 0, so that's it. So the next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to go into the grid and just go into the output, make sure you set a path for your simulation to save. So I've just set like a path in the desktop and I'm just going to name it like splash. All right, and then the very important thing is that you want to output for the compressed part, the output particles viscosity and viscosity for grid channels, and then you want to go to wet map and also turn on viscosity. All right, and the other thing that we want to do is turn on the steps per frame, turn it up to like 2 steps per frame. Is basically if you have a very high like motion object that the liquid is emitting from, the grid won't be able to catch it if we have less steps. So the more steps, the more accurate it's going to be. So if you go to the Chaos Group website and they have like a page for these, every little parameter is defined with a video example. So time scale, and this is like steps per frame, so you can see that SPF 5, SPF 15. So you can go there and check it out with an example, and it will give you a very clear idea what each of the settings are doing. So for now, I'm just going to turn it to steps per frame to 2. Time scale is basically how slow you want the simulation to be. So I'm just going to set it to like 0.6. And then the very important thing is wetting. So in this example, if I go back here, so for the first example, what I did was I set the wetting very low. So you can see that, if I turn this off, you can see that the liquid is just splashing around, you know, and it doesn't have like any stickiness to it. So, but in the second example, I've actually turned it up. So it seems to be sticking more together. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go and turn on sticky liquid to like 0.4. And the surface tension strength is also basically kind of like the strength between when the liquids are like colliding with each other, so it makes it stick together a little more. And again, if you go into this thing, we have here it is, surface tension, and then you have the strength and everything. So surface tension, everything is there, so you can see with the video example. So for now, I'm just going to set this to 0.5 as well. And the other thing that we need to do is we need to control this. We don't want it to just fall down and turn into liquid. We want it to do it randomly. So what I'm going to do is hit M. First off, I'm just going to set my renderer to V-Ray. So set, now it was set to Arnold. So I set it to V-Ray. Don't show this again. And I'm just going to hit M and create a noise map. So just go there to maps. Here, and I'm just going to be adding a V-Ray material, and just in the diffuse, I want to add a general noise. So the thing I'm going to do is I'm just going to turn it into fractal, and in order to see it visually, I'm just going to be adding a object like a torus knot, just like that. And I'm just going to hit M and apply this map to that object and show this in the viewport. So right now we can't really see the noise because, you know, we turn to fractal. And then these high and low values, the closer they are together, the more contrasty it's going to be. So yeah, right now you can see that it's there. So maybe 0.4 or just 0.43. Both of them 0.4 or 0.5-ish. Yeah, we just want to have some random noise. So I'm just going to delete this. And in order to use this, we need another helper of Phoenix FD. It's called the PHX Mapper or the Phoenix FD Mapper, which is going to be using a map to influence the simulation. So I'm going to go there. Make sure to turn off initializer. And for the channel, you can influence different channels using a map, so like velocity, smoke, but in this case we want to use viscosity. And for the map, I'm just going to click and add an output map. So go out of here, output, and just I'm going to hit M and drag the output map here as an instance. So meaning if I bring any changes, it'll be updated. And then what I'm going to do is this output amount basically controls like between 0 and 1. So if it is 1, the viscosity will be solid. And if it is 0, then the viscosity will be liquid. So the buildup, I want to use a map, and that map is the noise map. So what I'm going to do, I'm just going to drag this onto the mask as an instance. So basically, this noise map will be used, so the areas that are black is going to be liquid, and the areas that are white is going to be solid. And then it will just, you know, use like a random pattern. So we just don't want it to be like all at once. So we want it to be random. So we've used this noise map. I hope it makes sense. And if it doesn't, you can just rewind it, rewatch it, or ask me in the comments. And then at build-up time, I'm just going to turn it down to 0. All right, so we've done all this work, and let's see how it looks. So I'm just gonna go to simulation and hit start. All right, so I've simulated a couple of frames, and for some weird reason, I had to do the simulation over again, like the whole setup over again. And it seems like the problem was the Tiflow animated object, which originally I did it and it worked, but right now it doesn't. So even though it doesn't make a big difference, you guys try it out, and if it works, good. If not, then just use like the static object. All right, so if you're getting the same problem, just let me know in the comments. All right, so I've simulated a couple of frames, and if I go into grid, I need to, in order to see the mesh in the viewport, I went to preview, and then I turned on the show mesh, and I turned off the particle preview because we don't want to see the particles. All right, so now it's just a matter of you know, playing around with the different settings and increasing the resolution. So it's very low res right now, increase the resolution to maybe like 4 million, and now just simulate it. So now we're going to be getting a lot of detail and a lot of, high-end mesh. So this is the result, and still it's not like a lot. It's not very detailed, but I think it's okay. So the one thing that, like, I'm sure it will work for you guys if you're using an animated high flow scene or object. What we'll do is it will create more like a splash effect, and then you can go into the dynamic settings and make sure I've set the step time scale to 0.6, and the strength to 0.5, and the sticky liquid to 0.5 as well, so we get some more like sticky liquid sort of effects. But this is the gist of the tutorial and the effect, and you have to play around with it in order to get some custom results that you're looking for. So right now you can see that the liquid is like having a lot more splash and sticking together, which is really nice, and I like it. So you can go ahead and increase the resolution for your final results and like simulate over 100 frames and just add a light. So I've basically used, like, I've added a V-Ray plane for this. V-Ray plane. Just add like a very simple material to it. So just go here and drag one out and make sure it is dark. And I've basically used like a general, and for this, I've used a V-Ray material again. So dark black material. Add some reflection and give it some glossiness, and just apply it to the Phoenix FD source. And we'll basically go into V-Ray and add a light, which is going to be a dome light. So just add it here. So that is like my main setup lighting, and I've just added, like, for this second example, you see that we have this like orangish sort of light. So I've added like a side light, like an orange light. But now let's see here. Let's see how it looks. So I'm just going to go to the V-Ray IPR. So this is basically how it's looking, and it's looking pretty great, So that's basically my setup. So now you can just go ahead and bring it into After Effects or Premiere Pro or whatever compositing software that you're using. Add some motion blur, some color correction, and some sound effects, which will make it really cool. All right, so this was today's tutorial, and I hope you guys liked it and enjoyed it and learned something from it. And if you have any questions, make sure to go into my Effects Maniac channel, and in the videos section for this tutorial, just make sure to comment your questions and let me know what you guys want next. Any other tutorials or any other subjects, Tyflow, Phoenix FD, Maya, After Effects, or whatever, just tell me in the comments, and I'll make sure to do, whatever you guys want me to do. So, and again, don't forget to subscribe to our new channel. So if you go to my homepage, here's Audio Aura, and subscribe it and just support me, and I will make sure to create some really great music. Well, I'm not creating, my friend is creating, but this is like a teamwork. So we basically provide a lot of high quality content for you guys. So I hope you enjoyed it, and enough talking. Till next time, enjoy working.